In our previous lectures, we discussed commutation and the problems associated with commutations. Those problems were in the form of a sparking at the brushes. Let us summarize first the problems with commutation. So those were a sparking, due to inductive voltage kick, also known as LdI by dt voltage. We have seen how when a current changes from plus IC to minus IC in a coil undergoing commutation, then how a very large amount of voltage induces, LdI by dt voltage induces, and a sparking occurs at the brushes. Next, we discussed armature reaction. Here also, we observed the sparking due to MNS shift, magnetic neutral axis shift. Also, one more problem was associated with the armature reaction, that was weakening of flux. We saw how net flux per pole decreases due to armature reaction. Now, today we will discuss solution to these problems. So, in order to solve these problems partially or completely, the following three approaches have been developed. What are those approaches? So, we will discuss one by one. Brush shifting, second one, commutating poles, also known as interpoles, and third one is compensating windings. So we will discuss one by one. Let us start with the first one, brush shifting. So under this approach, remember this is our DC machine working as generator, the rotor is being rotated with the help of prime mover in clockwise direction. So we know that EMF will induce in the conductors as shown in the figure, right? We have already discussed it, how to get the polarity of EMF induced in the armature conductors, right? If this is velocity and this is field, right? So at any moment, draw this V and V, take V cross V, you will get the direction as shown, right? So still the load is not connected, electrical load is not connected across the output terminals of the DC generator. So what will happen? Remember, in this case, the field flux is in this direction, phi f, and when load is not connected, armature currents are not there. As soon as load will be connected, armature current will start flowing, right? So let us suppose the brushes are connected across the geometrical neutral axis. I am marking here, you know, along this axis, commutator is there and brushes are touching the commutator segments. We have discussed in detail already in our previous lectures, right? So just to show that the brushes are along the geometrical neutral axis. This is also MNA at no load. You may mark, you may write here MNA at no load. So MNA at no load coincide with the geometrical neutral axis, and brushes are placed along this. As soon as load is connected across the output terminals of DC generator, what will happen? Armature currents will start flowing as shown. So we can get the direction of armature flux. So this is into the plane, so downward like this, clockwise here, anti-clockwise. So we have net armature flux downward. Say this is phi A R, armature flux. So you will get resultant flux like this. This is phi R, resultant flux. So resultant flux will shift. So magnetic neutral, it will cause shifting of magnetic neutral axis along the direction of rotation in case of generator, right? So now the MNA will shift in the direction of rotation like this. Let us take this direction like this. This shifting in MNA depends on the load, amount of load current. If amount of load current is more, it will shift more. If this is less, it will shift less. If no armature current is there, no load current is there, it will be along this axis, right? So this will be perpendicular to this. So our MNA, this will be MNA at load, at this load. So this you may write MNA at load. This is MNA at load. So as MNA shifts, so earlier MNA was along this and brushes were placed along MNA. Now brushes are as it is, but this MNA has shifted. It means we know that MNA is the boundary between the two regions of poles. So this region is along south pole, this region is along north pole. That's why here now EMF will be induced of this polarity, and this region comes under this pole south. So similar to that, here this will be induced. Because of these induced EMFs, a sparking will occur across the carbon brushes. Brushes are generally carbon brushes, but that may be of graphite and mixture of carbon graphite across the brushes. So that is a problem. So to remove this sparking caused by the MNA shift due to armature reaction, remember that this MNA shift is because of the armature reaction, because once armature current flows, it affects on the main field flux. That's why shifting the resultant having its MNA perpendicular to this phi R, right? Earlier phi was this, so MNA was perpendicular. Now phi R has shifted, so MNA has also shifted. So to remove this sparking, this shifting approach tells that shift the brush position to the shifted MNA line, new position of shifted MNA, magnetic neutral axis. It means, it says that to remove this sparking, to stop this sparking, shift the brushes along this axis. So okay, we can stop this sparking across brushes due to MNA shift caused by armature reaction, but some other problems arises. As can be observed, that MNA shift is not fixed, that is load dependent. So someone has to monitor the load, and whenever load changes, someone has to adjust the position of brushes accordingly. That is also a problem. Second thing, When this DC machine is working as a generator, then as we already discussed in our previous lectures, that this shift occurs along the direction of rotation. In case this machine is working as a generator, in case this machine is working as a motor, that is, if operation of the machine changes from generator mode to motoring mode, then this MNS shift will be opposite to the direction of rotation. Someone has to take care of that also. That is also a burden. The most importantly, the bigger problem is that whenever we are going to connect brushes across this shifted, suppose this conductor is lying under these brushes, so no current will not show this current in these coils. How? Remember, the coils undergoing commutation will be shown like this. Suppose these are the segments and this is the coil under brush. So remember, the current through this will be IC, current through this will be IC, and current through this will be IC, current through this will be IC. During commutation procedure, we have already discussed this, and no current will be there in this. Suppose this is 2IC. Suppose for this current, so current coming from here, because these two segments are being shorted by this brush, so the current will get passed through this. Hence, no current in this coil. Similarly, no current in this coil. Earlier, current was there in these two coils. Suppose this brush position is not here, somewhere else, suppose somewhere else. Then this current will not get any path to flow, so no current here. So this current will flow through this IC, and means current will be there. So earlier current was there in the coils being shorted by the carbon brushes, but now current will not be there. It means redistribution of armature currents occurs. So as can be observed, now the axis of armature current has been changed. You can observe. So earlier axis was downward, this now this is main field flux phi f, and now the phi a has been changed, armature flux. So the resultant will be like this. In this case, we can observe that one component of armature reaction, armature flux, is opposing the main field flux, so that the resultant magnitude of resultant flux has been decreased from the previous one. This is a serious problem with this approach. It means we can conclude that this approach aggravates the flux weakening problem due to armature reaction, as can be observed that redistribution of the armature currents happens by shifting the brush positions as per the shifted MNA at load, at various loads. So that's why this approach is not effective approach, an obsolete one, hardly used in a small motors, cheap motors, but obsolete one, that is not up to the mark. That is not acceptable approach. So that's why this approach is obsolete approach. Now we will discuss the next approach, that is use of commutating poles or interpoles.